So we have learned that there are only two type of charges. So another important thing is that same type of charges, whether positive or negative, repel each other while different type of charges, one is negative, another is positive, always attract. So a question might come on this and we will discuss that how the question will come. So first question that you note down is that sometimes in your question paper, 1 mark question can come that suppose a glass rod is rubbed on silk cloth and both are getting charged. So what type of electric charging is this? Charging by conduction, friction, or third is induction or something else. So when we rub and charge, this is called charging by friction. Charging by friction. This is not charging by conduction. Charging by conduction we will see in the next diagrams. So here we have seen that there can only be two type of charge. The similar charges repel and the opposite charges attract. So there can be only two type of charges. So we will later name it positive and negative. Okay? So note these things down and the question what I have told you. So once we move, so on that day we also discussed this topic unification of electricity and magnetism. So the what is the unification of electricity and magnetism? So this is also good to understand for you that electricity and magnetism are unified. These are not two separate thing. So what is that? In the earlier classes you have seen that the electricity when passed through a wire can make an iron nail magnetic. So in a way you are seeing that any substance which is made of iron is being magnetic, becoming magnetic by passing, simple passing of electricity, which is the fundamental concept of electromagnetism. But same thing happens when the magnets are rotated. Rotating magnets produce electricity. That we will see in the chapter of alternating current. But you have to understand that electricity and magnetism are not separated. Both are a single concept, or you can say two sides of the same coin. From one side electricity, another side is magnetism. But both are highly connected. One side is electricity, another side is magnetism. Okay? So now let us discuss what is charging by conduction. Charging by conduction. So for charging by conduction, there is a very simple instrument called electroscope. What is this called? Electroscope. This is a very simple electroscope, but this is a little bit complicated one. This one is little bit complicated. This is the simple which you can make in your home as well. So what is an electroscope? So the construction of electroscope is very simple. You take a container and put a wire or any conducting material, either a paper clip which is made of any metal, a conducting piece of metal or wire. And then you take an aluminium foil and make a strip of aluminium foil like this. Aluminium foil strip. Once you take aluminium foil strip, fold it into half, and when this aluminium foil is folded, it will be like simply like this, two folds. See here, aluminium foil. So once aluminium foil is there, and this aluminium foil is attached to this wire, and the one end of wire is outside this container or glass bottle or plastic bottle. So now this has made. So what is this electroscope is used for what? So let us see. If we rub a glass rod on silk, definitely we know it is charged. But how do we know that it is charged or not? So this electroscope is used to understand that whether an object is charged or not. So when we put our object, there is a metal bob, this is a metal rod or wire, and this is your gold foil, gold leaves, or you can see this is the complex one. So they are using the gold leaves. In the house, you can use the aluminium foil as well to prepare this. So when an object is charged, if that is touched with this metal bob, let us see that if that object touches this, if there is a positive charge, so positive charge transferred to this bulb. Positive charge is transferred to this bulb, and through this wire it comes to this both of these aluminium foils. Since there is positive charge only, both the foils will acquire positive and positive charge, hence repel each other. So there is a difference between them. So there is a gap created in between them. In a way, you can say that the object was charged. If there was negative charge, the same thing will happen. It will make this bulb negatively charged, and the charge will come through this, and both parts of the foil become negatively charged and again repel each other. But what will happen if this object was not charged? Then no charge would be transferred, hence this foil will remain intact in closed position. This will not open like this. So in a way, we can tell that which objects are charged and which objects are not charged. Also, another fundamental property here is that when we touch one object to another, so this is charge is transferring, but charge is transferring by which means? Conduction. This is charge transfer by conduction. Previously we have seen charge transfer by friction when we rub, but here charge is transferred through conduction. So one mark question can come on this also, that give an example of charge transfer by conduction, then you can give a simple example of this electroscope. Okay, so you can again read this paragraph like any story. So this is, here it is shown that aluminium strip or paper strip, again this is folded, and then if it moves further, repel each other, then there is a charge associated with the object. Now let us understand the conductor and insulators. Once we understand the conductor and insulator, then we learn about third way of transfer of charge, that we will see later. So till now all you know that what are conductor and what are insulator. So let us say in terms of electricity, in materials which electricity easily pass through are called conductors. See, definition is given here, and definitely like younger students or class 8th or 9th, I will not dictate you. You have to write on your own what are conductors. Here is the definition given for conductor. Similarly, you find the definition for insulator. The material from which the electricity will not pass through easily and the resistance is very high are called insulator. So one thing what I have already taught in class 8, so I am telling you right now, nothing is perfect conductor and nothing is perfect insulator. The conductors have very high resistance. For conductor, resistance R is very high, and for conductors resistance is very low, and for insulators the resistance is very high. Very high means it is very high, but it is not infinite. For a perfect insulator, the resistance should be infinite. For a perfect conductor, resistance should be zero. But in the later chapters, we will see that for no material, resistance can be zero, and for no material, resistance can be infinity. So there is no perfect insulator as well as no perfect conductor. Please. I want to apologize for my writing, because I am writing this with a mouse, so the writing is not very good, so you have to bear with me. So now we have understood about conductor and insulators. There are third type of material whose conductivity is far less than conductor but much more than insulator. Those materials are called semiconductors. We will learn about semiconductor in chapter 14. So if we place conductor is highest conductivity, then lower conductivity is semiconductor, then further lower conductivity is insulator. We will understand that how this works, but for now it is more than sufficient. Okay, conductor, semiconductor and insulators.